Hi there. Today, we're going to quickly look at how to run WebAssembly applications using Rancher Desktop. Starting version 1.13, Rancher Desktop has added experimental support for running WebAssembly applications. This means that the feature needs to be manually enabled within your Rancher Desktop installation. Let's do that by navigating to the Preferences tab in the main window and clicking on the Container Engine option in the dialog box that opens up. As you can see here, we do not have WebAssembly support enabled by default. Clicking the checkbox next to it will allow us to manually enable that support within Rancher Desktop. Once we have the support enabled, let's take Rancher Desktop for a spin by deploying a sample application. Currently, directly running WebAssembly applications on Rancher Desktop is only supported with the MOBI runtime. This is because there's a bug in nerdctl that prevents Wasm from working with containerd. But we can still run WebAssembly apps on Kubernetes with the containerd runtime enabled. That is what we're going to do now. Deploy a sample Wasm app written in Rust onto the K3S cluster that comes bundled with Rancher Desktop. Note, the code I'm using in this demo is available in our official documentation linked in the description below. Let's get started by creating a deployment for the Spin Hello World application written in Rust. You must be wondering what runtime the application runs on inside the Kubernetes cluster. The answer to that would be Spin, the open source framework developed by the folks over at Fermion. Spin internally leverages the Wasm time runtime. It is also built to take advantage of the latest developments in the runtime, as well as the WebAssembly component model. Getting back to our demo, let us create this deployment by using the kubectl apply command. Once done, let us also create a cluster IP service and an ingress controller as shown. And now, for the moment of truth, we're going to test our application from the host by issuing a curl command as follows. As you can see, we were able to get a response from the Wasm application. If you would like to learn more about this and other new features from the latest version, check out the docs listed in the description section below. The section also contains an exhaustive list of resources that you can use to learn more about WebAssembly, the component model, and the Spin framework.